How's it going, mates? This is Mr. Charles. We're back with Clannad, visual novel goodness. Visual novel safe. Don't say any bad words. Holy Father goodness. I love it so much. I want to know where this Tomoya route goes. Are we actually going to get to the point where we're married? Marriage is one to look forward to. I'm taking this, like, no swearing thing way too seriously. But I look forward to this game a bit more now. I have something to, you know, aim for, aim towards. Anyway, yeah, previously, like, we got asked to, like, walk home with Tomoya, but she wasn't around lunchtime, and she was a bit late coming to, like, after school anyway. So what was happening? Was she doing something strange? Was she dealing drugs behind school? That's a possibility. So let's see where this goes, then. So what happened during lunch break? Oh, okay, that's the question I wanted to answer, to be honest. Oh, yes, I was getting an explanation. What, for the beating up of people during the drama club thing, you know? About what? About the student council election, of course. Elections are starting, Tomoya. Ah, is that so? I'm sure to vote. I'm sure to vote for the person I like, at least, if, you know, I actually care about this girl. I don't know if that's the case yet, but, you know. So you're really serious about this, huh? Of course I am. What, did you think I was joking? Well, no. My decision's been made. I won't be swayed from this. I mean, it's like your main story arc. I'd be surprised if you were. Is that so? What's wrong, Tomoya? You don't look very well. Do I look that way? You do. Then my face is probably telling you what I think about this. Really? You're not even going to try and support her slightly in the thing that she's always wanted to do? No, I want you to be a useless, like, piece of trash like me. Whatever. What do you mean? Say, Tomoyo. Stop and face Tomoyo. Do you really want to enter the student council? Yes. Didn't I tell you? My decision's been made, and I won't be swayed from this by something small. What, like me? You're trying to tell me that I'm an insect? Well, you know, some insects can actually build huge hives. Yeah, honey comes from bees, and that's some kind of flying insect. It's an insect if it's a Yu-Gi-Oh card, I guess. Then, how about you get swayed by something large instead? What the heck? What? Are we talking about the size of my genitals? What do you mean? I grab Tomoya's arm and draw her toward me. And then as her face comes in. Oh, shit! Yeah! Oh, I swore, damn it! Oh, I did it again! Oh, come on, I deserve a freebie! Oh, yes! I did not expect that! I kiss her! Tomoya should have been able to avoid it, but she didn't. She silently accepted it. Accepted her fate as my future wife. Oh, I'd love that, that's not gonna happen. I can't feel the sensation of Tomoya's breath. Is she holding it? Ah! I pull back my lips. But this time, as I try to pull back, Tomoya's lip go looking for mine. Once again, our lips meet. Beyond Tomoyo's ear, I see. Are we just casually making out in the corridor? Don't you think a teacher's gonna be like, you need to get back to your home, your young Mr. and Mrs. Alright, I see one of the students that are starting to go home. Oh dear, looks like someone's going to see a bit of action, a bit of peeping Tom. I wonder how many people's attention we caught like this, because that was how long our lips had stayed like that. I enjoy being with you. This is what I say as our lips part and I look into her eyes. The same eyes. They are the eyes of someone similar to me. She's a comrade I somehow managed to meet in a school like this. I want to live my school life together with you until the very end. I'd like that too. And let's do it. Let's spend our days having fun like we have up until now. Here's the thing though. We don't end up with this one. We end up with a tiny little baby girl who I don't want to end up with now. Now you've invested me in something I'm not allowed to have. You shove the chocolate cheesecake in my face. You take it away. I never see it again. Hooray! Do things like making a fool out of Sunohara. I'm even fine with getting into fights and running around in the morning. This might not actually be love at all. What? But if there's anything I'm sure of, it's that I want to be with Tomoyo. But I've already wait, we're gonna get rejected. I've already decided. There's something I just have to do. Why? Is that something even more important than spending time with me like this? It's not a matter of which is more important. I've made up my mind. I don't want to give up halfway. But I guess From the bottom of my heart, this is also something very important to me. Then what? What do you want me to do? Should I just pray for you to lose in the election? Why do you support her, you very bad person? Tomoya, do you really hate people in the student council that much? 1 year ago, I'm sure you would have been the same. That's true. Not to mention you'd also get very busy if you entered the council. You won't have the time to do stupid stuff like this anymore. Someone like her with a goal in life is already in a completely different league from me and Sunohara. I'll just work very hard so we can. By that time, things will already be different. In what way? I didn't answer that question. As I thought, it looks like all I can do is pray that you lose the... Stop being a trash plastic bag! It's the best I can come up with without swearing or being profusely bad. That's unfortunate! Then from now on, we'd be enemies! No! Oh, come on, she's like 50 times more attractive than Furukawa. Why? Gave it to me and took it away. This stuff better not happen with Miyazawa. If we end up liking her, kissing her, and ditching her, because you want to be a successful person when you're older, and you're just like, oh, Furukawa, well, she just wants to be a bakery person, I like that. Is that the reason we end up with an infant in the future? Oh, I swear, every single girl other than Furukawa better be fuck ugly when they're older, and I use that swear word sparingly. It's just like I've been given a cake, and then I find out there's ants in them, and then I find out there's slugs in them as well, and then I find out that literally my dead husband... I don't have a husband or a boyfriend. Alright, my dead girlfriend's in there. I don't want that in my life. No! Alright, I need to progress the story at some point. Sorry. Well, no. I prefer if we're lovers. So you still want to actually support her? Why don't you let her do her thing? Yeah? I feel like that might weaken your resolve a bit. Is that so? In that case, I'll be- Oh, thank God! Oh, we do have some logic. We have some logic in our life. God, it's so hard not to use F words right now. So, you don't mind? No, you sure are a hopeless guy. With a finger, I draw in Tomoyo's chin. And then, our lips meet once again. Tomoyo will certainly enter the student council. It's her we're talking about, so I think she'll definitely turn those dreams of hers into reality. Tomoyo has no desires in this world. For her, nothing exists but the dreams she has set for herself, meaning that all she can do is walk on straight ahead of this path of hers, overcoming any obstacles she faces. I think she should be able to walk that path, supported by the people around her. Although I don't know whether it's her destiny, or whether this is just something she attained by personal virtue. It's just that I feel that that is the kind of future she will have. And as I hold her in my arms, I become sure of it. Oh, that was a bit of an emotional roller coaster. Oh, thank God we're not in the dream world, because I can't be arsed with that right now. It's really not where I need to be. Cling. I hear the sound of the curtains being opened, and radiant light pierces my eyes. Question, when's Tomoyo going to finally meet my dad? Because I've noticed this whole playthrough... And even the last playthrough as well, to be honest, we haven't seen our dad. And I kind of want to know what happened. Like, fair enough with Masai-san, because we went to her place and like, oh, you know, you seem nice and all that, and then we'll travel back in time to understand the future. But like, in this scenario, we're actually always going to Tomoya's house, and yet we're not seeing the dad at all. Is that something I should be thinking about? Or does the dad not exist when we don't need him? I just think it's a bit unusual and a bit of a cretinous move, but alright. As a writer, you know, I mean, you should involve these things. It's not like you're gonna avoid this guy if he lives here. I hear the sound of the curtains being opened. Yeah, I did that. It's morning, Tomoya! Huh? I squint with half-opened eyes and confirm that there is a female student standing in my room. I mean, she's been here like the past 2 days. 3 isn't really a surprise anymore. I see. So going out with her means that this kind of morning will become part of my everyday lifestyle. To be honest, it's pretty tough. Tomio? What? Okay, this isn't serious, is it? Huh? Although our time together was short, it was fun. I once again surrendered to my drowsiness and turned over in my bed. Tomio, are you joking? You're joking, right? Hurry up and say it's a joke! If you don't, I don't know what I should do! I rise quickly from my bed! Tomio's sitting on the corner of the bed looking down at the floor. Tomio, you! What? Really are unexpectedly cute, aren't you? Yes, I swore again. I'm not doing good in that sense, but why are we being... I wouldn't mind if this was what happened with Furukawa. Furukawa deserves it. You know, it's even worse. Read some Sigmund Freud lately. Been surfing YouTube. And I learned a new saying. In every lie, there's always a little bit of truth. Tomio doesn't really like Tomio that much, does he? He likes little Furukawas. Oh, please. Please. Like, at the very least, if the playthrough ends and, like, you know, I'm forced with Furukawa in another playthrough, fine. But if this playthrough, I end up being like, oh, I actually like Furukawa along, I will actually stab something. I mean, I couldn't do it to my cat. I'll stab, like, a cereal box. We don't have any cereal in this house. I'll stab a box. I've got, like, plenty over there still, okay? I hate this. I hate this so much. It's good that the retort to those words is simple. Because it sure sounds like you're picking a fight. Why you? I just told you you're cute, didn't I? Before that, you added unexpectedly. Yeah, I kind of did that without thinking. She's quite shocked at these kind of things. Still, I said that we were joking before. I hope someone's taken the hint. However, I know of a way to dull that sharpness. I gently move my hand behind Tomio's neck. And then... flip. Tomio shakes off my arm and stands up. Huh? You really don't have any dignity in the morning, do you? No, or any decency. And you shouldn't be so clingy all of a sudden, just after yesterday. It'll almost be like I'm some kind of loose woman. Ah, I see, that's too bad. However, it's not that I dislike it. In a way, I was actually happy about what you tried. But what made me happy in the first place was... Tomio cuts the conversation halfway. She must have gotten embarrassed, actually seeing it herself. Giving in to my seductive moves, I guess. Whatever moves this guy has, because so far his moves have been playfully dumping you. That's the move. Come on, hurry and get ready. Otherwise, we'll have to run again. Can we at least apologize or something? I really want us to, like, take back what we just said. Tomio picks my bag and my school uniform up off the floor. An opening! I jump up, swooping down upon her, and cling tightly to her back. For now, let's try pushing her onto the bed. Oh, and you're going to get injured for that. Someone's going to get a combo to the face. That's what I thought, but the one whose legs and arms are spread out right now are mine. Ooh. How about you just be happy like Sunohara, knowing that I'm out of your reach anyway? Just now, I thought that I'd love to see the guy who could actually be your boyfriend, but then I realized that guy is actually me. That's right, Tomoya. It's you. So if you like, I'll grab a mirror for you. Nah, I really don't want to see him now. Really? He's quite handsome, you know. Perverted, though. That's how all guys my age are, you know. I jump to my feet to feel united. Hey, hey, hey. Hurry, I'm finished getting dressed already. So I need to actually get ready. I want to kiss, but I can hold on. I need to care about her for who she is. Do apparently. It's the only option today as well. These days are going to end up going much quicker apparently, but there's still plenty of days left. We got till May 11th, but then there's a huge gap between the 6th and the 11th. I'm just saying, I am using a walkthrough while I do these because I'm more curious in the story than actually finding what I need to find. I get all ready, I throw off a half-assed response and start preparing. Come on, I have to change my pants, so look the other way. Maybe you want to see my big sausage willy? Okay. Drop my pajamas to the floor and start getting into my uniform. Say, Tomio, You're not in a bad mood, are you? Not really. I see. Well, that's good then. Tomio, are you fine?
being with a girl like me, who isn't girly at all. Dude, I actually find that attractive in a lot of women. What are you on about all of a sudden? Once I finished putting on my pants, I turned toward Tomoyo. If I were a normal girl, I'm sure that I'd let you do as you like. Yeah, but that's not a good thing for this guy. He needs some discipline right now. Well, I guess a normal girl would at least not go and make us do a barrel roll in midair. I understand. Tomoyo slowly faces me. Really sassily, I might add. I don't agree with what you said earlier, but I don't mind doing it. Are you serious? Yeah, so come on, we don't have much time. Doing it with foresight makes all of this pretty awkward, though. What's wrong? You don't have to force yourself if you don't want to. Though, having said that, it'd be pretty shocking if you gave up on it now. You really are cute, aren't you? And what does that mean? As she pouts uncomfortably, I take myself to her mouth by surprise. Oh, so we end up kissing anyway. Well, at least that worked out in the end. Hooray! That was sweet and innocent. But I think I'm going to end the episode here. Now the main man has entered the party. But if you want to play the game for yourself, see if you can do it without swearing as I am trying to do, there'll be a link to the game in the description down below. And without further ado, a little bit of Squid Chance this time. See ya!